We get asked all the time, will my new Fortigate work with my UniFi switches and APs? And the answer is yes. There's a few things you have to do to get this all up and running smoothly, and that's what we're doing today. This video is a continuation of our Fortigate small business setup video. So if you haven't seen it, make sure you go back and watch it before continuing. But if you already have a few VLANs up and running on your own, feel free to jump in here. With all that said, let's dive in and get your Fortigate working with your UniFi network. We're going to do two things today, and it's not going to take much time at all. First, we're going to get our UniFi devices adopted into a UniFi network controller while on a Fortigate network. And two, we're going to configure up our VLANs and SSIDs based on the video before. So if you haven't got to this point, you should go back and watch that video. But if you already got some VLANs set up and you're confident they work, let's jump right in. So here's what we got. We got our Fortigate 70F. We got a small UniFi switch, and really this could be any UniFi switch. It'll work just fine. And a U7 Pro AP. First thing we want to do is actually create a UniFi DNS entry in the Fortigate. This is not required at all if you have a local UniFi controller on the same subnet. Say for example, we put a cloud key on that 10.10.0 subnet range. It will just automatically find it. You can skip this step. But for me, my controller is going to live in the cloud. So let me show you how to do that. And you could just use the old set and form method where you SSH into it, but having this DNS entry means anytime I plug a fresh brand new device from UniFi into this network, it just automatically pops up in my cloud controller to adopt. We got signed in here to our Fortigate 70F, and we got to enable a feature here inside of feature visibility. So we go to system, feature visibility, and then we go over to the DNS database. Basically, this allows us to enter custom DNS information into the Fortigate. Now with that feature turned on, we have to make sure our DHCP server is handing out the .1 address so that DNS inquiries do get sent to the Fortigate. Super simple. Let's go ahead and go up to network, interfaces, and then we'll click on this internal network, which is our main management network, and click edit. And we'll scroll way to the bottom here, and we're going to select specify. So I went ahead and typed in the 10.10.0.1 as the DNS server for this network. This means all DNS inquiries will be sent to the Fortigate on this network. Now we actually got to go make an entry for our UniFi server. So let's go ahead and go over to DNS servers. Got to go ahead and create a DNS service on interface. So we'll go ahead and select our internal interface, and we'll make it recursive and click OK. Down below, we'll go ahead and create a database so we can put in the UniFi information. Now, the thing about this, we want to put UniFi as the DNS zone and domain name for this entire database. It's a bit funny. It's trying to do that whole home.local thing. Now, we don't want anything to be .unify. We just simply want a DNS entry where if you query the router UniFi, it sends over the IP address of my cloud-hosted UniFi controller. So here, we'll go ahead and click create entry, and we'll make the host name at, and this is what that's doing. That is saying if you want to go to the FQDN of just UniFi, you need to go to this IP address here, which is my cloud hosted UniFi controller. Now we'll go ahead and pull up my UniFi controller and see if any new devices are pending adoption. And you can see my U7 Pro there, but my switch didn't pop up. This is actually a good example. This isn't entirely unexpected. I may now have to reboot these devices because they've been on the whole time. They need to pull a new DHCP address so they can send their default UniFi query to the right DNS server. Let me go ahead and reboot these. And with all reboots, that took way longer than I thought it would, but with the power of the clock wipe, we're back. So we see here on the screen, we got our devices popping up pending adoption. I'm going to go ahead and click adopt. Now from here, we only really have a few things left to do. Let's go ahead and head over into the gear icon. We'll go ahead and click network. So we have our default network here. And the one thing you want to know is the subnet here is wrong. It doesn't know that we set this to be the 10.10.0.whatever subnet for management. Now with the current version of UniFi, you can't change that. That's not a big deal. You don't got to worry about that because there is no router from UniFi on this network. We just got to make sure it has the VLAN IDs correctly. So remember, we have VLAN ID 20 for employees and VLAN ID 30 for guests. So let's go ahead and set that up. We click new virtual network and we'll type an employee. And the router, of course, will be left to third-party gateway, and we'll type in VLAN ID 20. Just the same, we'll go ahead and add in guest with VLAN ID 30. And that took care of the layer 2 portion of this, adding the VLAN IDs into the switch. And now we can create SSIDs for each one of them and hand them out. Start with the employee network first by selecting the SSID and password. And then we just have to select the correct network. Of course, with employee, we want to select VLAN 20. Now we'll head over and create the guest network, which we're still going to put a password on it just for this test. Again, just make sure you do select the correct VLAN ID here. We'll click add network. And now we can actually jump on these new SSIDs with our cell phones and test them out. I already know this works, so I want to show you the last piece of this, how to set up the ports on a switch. Now, if we head back over here into UniFi devices and open up the Flex, we can click on the port manager. You can see here, my connection to the Fortigate is on port 5. I have my computer plugged in here on port 4, and then port 1 is still coming up from the provision for the access point, but rest assured that is port 1. Let's actually take a look at that right now. What we want to have here is the native VLAN tag set the default, and then we're going to allow all. Now, if you didn't want to hand out all of the VLANs you wanted, you could prune this down by going into custom and selecting the ones you want to hand off. But for the access point, it needs both of those to hand out the SSID. If we went over here into port 2, maybe we wanted to configure this up for guest access. You know, this could be a 48 port switch, so we have to manage all of these, but let's just do port 2. In the guest instance here, we want to go ahead and type in guest for the port name. And then we'll select the network as guest. We'll apply that change. So now if you plug into that port, you're on the network that we set up for guest on the Fortigate. That's really all we have to do. It's just as easy as that. You can take this information and build out a super large network with as many UniFi switches and APs as you want and still have a Fortigate running all of its UTM features. If you found this video helpful, make sure you like and subscribe to Crosstalk Solutions.